Hi, this is Expose, and I'm Kay Armanosa. I'm here with Joram Luursen. He's from the Netherlands. He's a director from of a movie called Alles is Familie.
De A is Van Arendt, de man van Jeannette. Al 40 jaar gaan zij van Rettekert.
Yes. Now, Joram, is this your first visit to Indonesia?
No, I think I was here in 2006 or 7, because I made a film back then in 2004, and it was screened in Jakarta on the Film Festival.
Jakarta Film Festival, okay. And so did you only go to Jakarta?
No. Then I also visited Bali, but I didn't go to the coast. I went to Ubud.
Oh, okay, but there wasn't a screening in Bali in 2007.
This is the first time.
Okay, this movie, Alice is Family, what is it about? Don't give too much spoiler, though.
No. Okay, I will tell it as a trailer.
Okay.
if you see the movie, it's a multi-storyline romantic comedy. And it gives a feeling about the Dutch society nowadays, about the love lives of the different characters who are all family. Mm-hmm. That's why it's called Alles is Familie, all is family, which means Alles is Familie in Dutch.
All is family, okay.
Yeah.
And the English translation is the family way?
Yes, English market or American market, it's called the Family Way.
Okay.
And it's you follow the different characters of this family. The family, the Rover, they're called, and you have those two parents. They are in their 60s, and the mother of the family wants to divorce the father because the children are grown up, and she wants to be in love again, and she's not with her husband, she says, but her husband is very quiet and kind, and he helps her actually finding her new life. It's not a very nice character, the mother, I think. And then you have those three, they have three children. One was married, but she died, so they have this son-in-law with the two children, and they also have two real sons. And one of them is married, and they're both very successful. He's a music producer, and she is a writer, and they're kind of glamour couple. And then there's this third brother, and he is the black sheep from the family. He doesn't have a girlfriend. He has lots of girlfriends, but he doesn't have a stable relationship.
Okay.
He's a cook, but he never gets a job for a week, because he cannot
hold a job.
He cannot hold anything, because he's afraid of holding things.
Ah, that's a commitment issue there.
That's the thing. So they all have their issues, and the successful couple, they want to have a child, but they find out in the beginning of the film that they cannot get children because he is, how do you call that? He onvruchtbaar? No, he's not impotent. His seed does not work. He has dead seed.
Infertile.
Yes, he's infertile.
He's infertile,
right.
So he can't have children. So,
and then his wife, she really wants a child, and she's very persuasive.
Very persistent about it.
Yes, so she says, I'm going to find somebody who can give me the semen, and then we adopt this. That's
just
pretty
like
normal way of
artificial insemination.
Right. And she wants Nobel Prize winning semen, as she says. So they'll find the best partner she can get. And then this her husband, he gets crazy. He thinks my woman, Nobel Prize winning semen. So then he comes up with the idea that they get the semen from his brother.
What?
But he hates his brother.
Oh God!
And then and then he thinks that's a perfect idea, because when she finds out that it's his semen, well, she will never get involved with him, so she stays with me. But he says, well, she will never do this because she hates me. And then they come up with a plan that
to somehow get the semen into her.
No. That no. There's a friend who no, because she wants it. She wants IVF. So this friend who is a doctor and actually is in love with this guy. It's a very difficult story to tell in a. But
oh God, this is interesting.
And so she gets pregnant of the brother without knowing.
Without knowing that this is the brother's semen.
Right. And then when in the end she finds out, well, there's a lot of things going on, and you will find out in the film when you see.
How many movies have you produced?
I've made 7 movies, and the last one I just finished, and it's not out yet in Holland. Mm-hmm. But so there's 6 movies being in cinema.
Okay.
With my name as a director on it, and one will come, and I'm planning to make one at the end of this year. So that's number 8. My first film was about a boy who wants to become a professional soccer player in Orange, it's called, and he wants to become into the national team, which plays in Orange. He tries to get this goal, and I thought it up with a friend who I play soccer with.
Is there a certain thing that spark or trigger your inspiration?
No, it's
for
more the other way around. I get a lot of scripts and ideas on my desk, and if it sparkles my imagination, then I'll go further
then
with
you'll,
it.
Okay, then you
so
decide.
So most of the time it goes like that, or I have a couple of friends who are good writers, so I start to just walk around with them and toss ideas, and then in the end there comes something up and we start writing, and sometimes it goes to nothing, and sometimes it goes to a script.
Do you have a specific genre that you kind of feel like, you know, you'd rather
No, I like switching genres because it makes you sharp, and it's always a different a different way of working. If you work for family, you have to attract the children, but also the parents, because children always go with their parents.
Yeah.
And I am a parent, and I saw a lot of movies which my children loved and I really hated. So then I thought, well, it's a goal if you make a family film that the parents also enjoy watching the same movie.
Such
and
idea.
Like this movie is not as the subject I told you the subject is not for young children, but so I could be a little bit more intelligent. The humor is, but it's with humor. Most of the films that I made were kind of funny.
Okay.
And it always has a deeper layer in which there's emotions involved, and so sometimes the films turn out to be some more emotional
drama,
more drama than the other. But most of them are light comedy kind of films.
Let's talk about your visit to Bali. This is not your first, but this is your first screening.
It is on a wonderful spot, I would say.
Exactly. Are you excited?
Yes, I am.
All right.
I think this is the best venue I've ever had a screening in.
Okay, so do you travel the world to, you know, have screening for your movie?
Yeah, and sometimes it's very disappointing. Then there's hardly 2 people in the cinema, and it's in a crappy environment. Uh-huh. But the environment here is so beautiful, and the hotel and the hospitality, it's great.